Welcome back to Strong Successful Male. So for today, I'm going to write an article titled Outcry Over South Africa's Multiple Husbands Proposal. And a big shout out to Carrie for sending me this article. And guys, this article is coming from the other side of the world. We're talking about South Africa today. I've been doing a lot of articles coming from different parts of the world this week. I've done a couple dealing with India. Yesterday, one with Sweden, and now we have South Africa. So it's pretty interesting to see how things are around the world. Anyhow, getting to the point, apparently, South Africa has a very liberal constitution that allows same-sex marriages as well as polygamous relationship marriages for men, where it's the guy with multiple wives. Why any guy would want to have multiple wives is beyond me, beyond anything I could understand, but okay, whatever. Now the government is trying to make it that women can have multiple husbands. Okay, and obviously, as you can imagine, there are a lot of people that aren't very happy with this, conservative groups and so forth over there. And again, back to the whole thing, how knowing what I know and what many of you guys now know, either what you've experienced personally, what you've learned over the years on channels like mine, or just people you know in your life, you certainly would wonder why any guy, knowing what he knows in today's world, would get married today in 2021. Knowing how it is. Right? How deck is stacked against guys. Let alone a guy having multiple wives. I mean, dealing with one would be the biggest pain in the ass as it is, but multiple ones. But now guys are actually going for the idea that they would share a woman, that they'd be married, she'd be the head of the family, and would have multiple guys orbiting around her to basically wait on her hand and foot and basically be in the role of the wife. Okay? But it doesn't surprise me too much because nothing surprises me anymore how the ugly teeth of effinism has taken a bite pretty much of the entire world, except for small sections. And it's no surprise to me that you can get guys who actually would think this is a good idea. Right now, it's one thing if you're single and you suspect a woman that you're seeing and hooking up with is hooking up with other dudes, which is pretty common. But it's different if she's actually riding the carousel in a marriage and rotating between different dudes. I just don't get what any guy would go along with this. But again, so many guys have been just brainwashed by these effinists and these ideas that no surprise there, because it puts the effinist movement, not about equality, it's about emasculating men and putting them in a feminine role, a subservient role to women. Of course they go along with this, and so many guys have been brainwashed about this all over the world. But anyhow, I'm going to get into this, guys. It's pretty interesting hearing what's going on in South Africa. So it starts off. A proposal by the South African government to legalize polyandry when a woman has more than one husband at the same time has led to howls of protest from conservative quarters. This does not surprise Professor Kallis Makako, a renowned academic on the topic. Bear with me on the pronunciations here, because I have not been to South Africa, so I have no idea here, but just bear with me here. The objections are about control, he told the BBC. African societies are not ready for true equality. We don't know what to do with women we cannot control. I got news for you. You never controlled them. Let's be honest here. You never control. And the ones, and if you did, it's rare. South Africa has one of the world's most liberal constitutions, embracing same-sex marriages for all and polygamy for men. Businessman and TV personality Musa Muselku, who has four wives, is among those opposed to polyandry. He says, he's quoted as saying, "This will destroy African culture. What about the children of those people? How will they know their identity?" asked Mr. Muselku, who stars in South African reality TV show about his polygamous family. He again says, the women cannot now take the role of the man. It's unheard of. Will the woman now pay Lobola, the bride price, for the man? Will the man be expected to take her surname? See what I'm talking about here? Now, this guy they're mentioning, who is a TV personality, he says he has four wives. If you guys take a moment to click on the link of this article in the description, you'll scroll down, you'll see a picture of this dude with his four wives. And let's just say they're not, in my opinion, they're not exactly lookers. They're big girls, okay? And when I say big girls, I'm being nice here. They are large and in charge, okay? So you guys can take a look at that and see if you agree with me there. But certain cultures like bigger girls, so, you know, to each their own. But again, this guy's dealing with four wives. I mean, you want to talk about idea of hell here. Goes on under secret unions. Professor Machoko researched polyandry in his country of birth, neighboring Zimbabwe. He spoke to 20 women and 45 of them, 45 co-husbands who practiced it. And even though such marriages are socially taboo and not legally recognized, says polyandry, because it's shunned by parts of society, has been forced underground. The secrecy is similar to the one found in Freemasons, he said. When confronted by somebody whom they do not trust or do not know, they even deny that such marriages exist. All this is because of fear of reprisals and persecution. The participants in Professor Machoko's study all live separately, but were committed to the polyandrous union and were open about it among themselves. It's an interesting world we're in, guys. No matter what your view on this particular subject it is interesting. I love reading these articles from all over the world because I do love to travel. Now that part of it's opening up again, I'm now going to start traveling soon again. I'm really looking forward to that because I've been stuck here in Massachusetts for over a year and a half, and I've had enough of this place. There are good things about Massachusetts, but there's definitely need to escape for a while. But anyhow, I love learning these things about the world and seeing how things go. But this whole idea, and now the woman's the head of the family, and all these different dudes she's going to be married to, they're going to make that legal there. Holy shit. Yeah, let's just see how well that goes. Goes on, one wife nursed the idea of wanting to be a polyandrous woman when she was in grade 6, age 12 years old. After learning about how the queen bee and hive host many bee co-husbands, the professor said. When she was an adult, she started having you-know-what with multiple partners who were all aware of each other. Riding the carousel. Yeah, well, let's just see. It doesn't say how old she is, but said she was in the 6th grade, 12 years old. She liked the idea of the queen bee and all the male bees subservient to her, okay? And I guarantee you, they said that this country has a very liberal constitution. I'm guessing that the feminist movement was doing its job with the at that age, okay? It's like, wait a second, the guys should all be serving me. It's like, who the hell do you think you are? But at the end of the day, it's the guy's fault. It's the guy's fault for going along with this, right? But how many clueless guys are out there? I wouldn't have this channel if there weren't a whole world of clueless guys. No offense, guys, but a lot of them are clueless and have and need help, right? Or guys have been that were clueless once, but now know what the fuck's going on and see things differently. But what guys would go along with this willingly? Goes on. Four of her current 9 co-husbands were in the first group of the boyfriends. This chick has 9 co-husbands. I really want to know what she looks like. It doesn't show what she looks like, unfortunately, but 9 dudes? What the hell are these guys thinking? In polyandry, the woman often initiates the relationships and invites the husbands to join her union. Some pay the bride price, others opt to contribute to her livelihood. She has the power to remove a co-husband if she believes he is destabilizing her other relationships. What guy would go along with this? I don't get it. Anybody from South Africa watching this, or anybody that happens to know somebody in a situation like this, please comment below. I like to hear about this. Or email me. Email me personally and let me know about what you've experienced, what you've seen. Professor Machoko said love was the main reason the men he interviewed said they had agreed to be co-husbands. They did not want to risk losing their wife. What do you mean risk losing their wife? They're sharing her with multiple dudes. They lose her most nights of the week. Okay, and love? Come on, here. Again, but as I've told you guys before, a man's version of love is not the same as a woman. Uh-uh. You know, it's if he can provide and things like that. You know, if he can no longer provide or he no longer has his status or things like that that drew her to him in the first place, bye-bye love. Some men also refer to the fact that they did not satisfy their wives, you know what, agreeing to the suggestion of a co-husband to avoid divorce or affairs. So they're going to agree to have some other dude take care of business when they can't, just because, God forbid, they would get a divorce or affairs to go on. Well, you could say that there is an affair going on because she has multiple husbands and other dudes are doing her. who would go along with this? But again, if these guys were raised in households where their mothers ran the show and were bossy and had subservient men around, and this is what these boys learned when they're young and grew up to be adult men, they think that's just how it is, right? I guarantee you, most of the guys watching this as I'm reading this now are like, what the fuck? They could ever imagine that. Another reason was infertility. Some men consented to the wife taking another husband so that she could have children. In this way, the men saved face in public and avoided being stigmatized as emasculated. What do you mean worrying about being emasculated? You share your wife with multiple husbands. That's a lot of sausage going to her that's not yours. And you're worried about being perceived in public as emasculated? You're going to go along with that so, like, that way then you don't feel bad about yourself? Says here, the clerics are upset. It says, Professor Machaco said he was unaware of the polyandrous marriages in South Africa. Nevertheless, gender rights activists, well, here we go, have asked the government to legalize such unions in the interest of equality and choice, as the law currently permits a man to take more than one wife. Their proposal has been included in a document officially known as the Green Paper that the government has released for public comment as it embarks on the biggest overhaul of marriage laws since the white minority rule ended in 1994. It says here, it is important to remember that the Green Paper sets to uphold human rights, and we cannot lose sight of that, says Charlene May, an advocate at the Women's Legal Center, a law firm that fights for women's rights. She says, we cannot reject law reform because it challenges certain patriarchal views in our society. Here we go. I'm waiting for the toxic word. I'm waiting for the all those other buzzwords that usually come at this point. She says, the document also proposes giving legal recognition to Muslim, Hindu, Jewish, and Rastafari marriages. While this has been largely welcomed by the communities concerned, the proposal to legalize polyandry has been condemned by clerics who hold seats in parliament. The leader of the opposition, African Christian Democratic Party, the ACDP, Reverend Kenneth Michaud, said it would destroy society. He says, there will come a time when one of the men will say, you spend most of the time with that man and not with me. And there will be conflict between the two men, he added. Yeah, and you know what? I bet you she'll love every minute of it. Think about it. Any guys ever seen that show, The Bachelorette, in this American reality show where a whole bunch of dudes compete over one chick? The women love the drama. They love all those guys competing over her and carrying on and fighting and doing all these bullshit to kiss her ass. If you ever watch that show, I mean, not that I sit down and watch that show, but I've seen enough clips of it to just, it's hilarious. It's both sad and hilarious that these guys go along with this, right? But these guys are the biggest bunch of beta male simps, blue pill guys you're ever going to see. Occasionally they'll get one or two dudes that actually kind of get it, and they actually end up hooking up with a girl and getting her, and then they usually kick her ass to the curb once the show's over. But anyhow, don't tell me that she's not going to like all these dudes fighting over her. He says, for his part, the leader of the Islamic al-Jamal party, Ghanif Hendricks, said, you can imagine when a child is born, more DNA tests will be needed to discover who the father is. Right? She says that it's almost going to be like, you get some puppies or some kittens, and, you know, apparently the female, the mother of the puppies, the mother of the kittens could have multiple dogs or cats, depending where you're looking at it, with her. It's going to be kind of the same thing here. Children of the family. As for Mr. Masilka, he urged South Africans not to take the principle of equality too far. He says, just because something is in the Constitution, that does not mean it will be good for us. Asked why it should be any different for women, given he had four wives, he replied, I've been called a hypocrite because of my marriages, but I'd rather speak now than be silent. All I can say is that it is un-African. We cannot change who we are. But Professor Machaco said polyandry was once practiced in Kenya, the Democratic Republic of Congo, and Nigeria, and is still practiced in Gabon, where the law allows it. How about that? This is interesting. I had no idea about this stuff. He goes on, with the arrival of Christianity and colonization, the role of the woman became diminished. They were no longer equal. Marriage became one of the tools used to establish the hierarchy. Professor Machaca said concerns about children born from a polyandrous union were rooted in patriarchy. Of course, that's, of course, is what he says. The final quote he says is, the question of children is an easy one. Whatever children are born from that union are the children of the family. Well, there you go. I'm sure you guys have now learned something new about this stuff going on in South Africa. Let's just see if something like this may expand other cultures. Who the hell knows? But anyhow, very interesting there. But again, like I said, in today's world, knowing what I know, what many of you guys know, why any guy would go into just with one wife, let alone a dude actually having multiple, and to deal with that. I mean, any of you guys that are married right now, been married, you know darn well, you come home at the end of a busy day, you set one foot in the door and, you know, about everything, let alone four. And there's going to be drama and fighting and carrying on. Years ago, I mean, 15 years ago, this show came out called Big Love with Bill Paxton. And he was in a polygamous marriage. He had like three wives, I think. And this guy, just all the crap he was dealing with. I only watched a few episodes of the first season. It was a little creepy for me, so I just couldn't take it. But the point is, him dealing with that. But now, on the other side, guys agreeing to multiple guys with one woman. Okay? And just, I just can't believe it. But at the end of the day, I really think it's the programming of this effinous programming that we get these guys to actually go along with this. And of course, if they grew up in households where the mother was dominant and ran the show. So, but anyhow, guys, thought you'd find that very interesting today. Again, South African government working to legalize that. Should be interesting to see how that, how things go with that. So, all right, guys, that's it for today. Be sure to comment down below. Let me know what you think about this. And be sure to like the video, share with your friends, and subscribe. And I'll catch you next time.